Okay, so I want to talk about this hormone called cortisol. Cortisol in the body is the hormone that reacts to all types of stress. So if you experience physical stress, mental stress, losses, trauma, maybe poor eating, watching the news, pregnancy, menopause, a fight with your spouse, a divorce, that's what triggers cortisol. So cortisol then adapts the body and changes the body to adapt to all this stress, okay? So on this picture right here, you can see in SIBA, these are all the reactions of body stresses: inflammation, brain fog, cholesterol, ulcers, diabetes, allergies, asthma, sleeping problems. Now, what's very fascinating is all these symptoms are really reactions to stress, but medically they're treated as a disease when they're really symptoms of high cortisol, which you could see right up here. This is high cortisol. These are all the symptoms of high cortisol. Yeah, interesting, isn't it? So what we're going to do is we're not going to treat all these symptoms. We're just going to help rid the byproduct of what stress has left in the body. So when you're 18, you have very little stress. As years go on, stress accumulates from things like, you know, college, having two children, then having a divorce, and then stuck with the two children by yourself, and then we got menopause, all these different things. See, stress accumulates. So here you are, little stress, and now we got a big stress. So what happens is in the adrenal gland, which is making these hormones, what's interesting is it does not have an off switch. So you remember on that graph we showed you? That tall dial represents the on switch. The small dial represents the off switch. But with the adrenal, it only has an on. It does not have an off switch. So what does that mean? It means that your body, over time, has so much cortisol or so much stress that this is stuck on. So part of the adaptation to this hormone is belly fat. So if you try to exercise, you try to do sit-ups, eat better, it won't touch it because this is a dominating hormone. Okay? So this is why people can't lose weight, is because of the accumulated stress that builds up. And they don't realize that, number one, stress accumulates, and they realize that it affects the hormones, and they don't realize that this hormone is a dominating hormone, and that can nullify all this, the other fat-burning hormones.